Thank you. Pray forgive me. I was delayed.
It's fine, Orange. We're all here now.
Let's get down to business then, shall we? Come what may, we must prevent the Telophoroi's plans from coming to fruition. At present, I see two paths for gathering the information which may aid us in achieving that goal. The first involves an investigation into the change which has come over Charlian, not to mention the recent inscrutable behavior of the Forum. As most of you know, the 99 members of the Forum are elected from the general populace. This alone guarantees a plethora of opinion with regards to foreign policy. The Bibliotheques, for example, are a group of conservatives which would have Charlian focus on recording history, while remaining entirely uninvolved in the making of it. And at the other extreme, we have advocates for proactive diplomacy and direct intervention. My grandfather Galef was one such member, as was Archon Louisois. Yet despite our diverse factions and philosophies, the recent vote to deny Eorzea's request for assistance was unanimous. Even more concerning was the fact that many cited other, more pressing duties as justification for their recalcitrance.
Forshino's refusal in Gridania had those same undertones. 'Twas as if, having stared unblinking into the face of impending doom, he had simply turned away to pursue something more important. But what could that possibly be?
A mystery indeed, and one which I ask for your help to solve. Our future may depend on it. As for our second potential path, it concerns a request made directly to the students of Baldessian. Our organization was founded primarily to study strange and unexplained phenomena the world over. Mysterious relics and ruins, arcane disturbances, and so forth. Compared to our more isolationist Charlian colleagues, we have strong connections overseas, namely with scholars and academics who share our passion for the unknown. The request in question comes from one such acquaintance, Nidana, an alchemist residing in distant Thavnair. Her missive describes the sudden appearance of a tower, and the subsequent summoning of what I can only assume is a lunar primal. In response to this threat, the satrap of Rads-at-Han, the individual who governs the city-state, has instructed the alchemists to find a means to deal with the spire.
The artisans of that land are heirs to an ancient tradition, one rather unlike that of their Uldan counterparts. 'Tis possible, nay, probable, that they have gleaned truths unattainable by Eorzea or her Far Eastern allies.
They do, in fact, appear to have a strategy in mind, though it will require further research. To that end, they have requested an introduction to a capable warrior shielded by the blessing of light.
Assuming we divide our forces to pursue both of Kra's lines of inquiry, and having you join the group heading to Thavnair would seem the obvious choice. But the investigation in Sharlion is of vital importance as well. Equal, I think, to the Thavnairian one, given that the fate of the world may hinge on the results of both.
Yes, it is quite the quandary. Though it is a great imposition and an altogether too common one, our efforts would be more likely to succeed were you to lead the charge on both fronts. You are indeed our champion. As to which task to tackle first, we will defer to your decision. Let us next decide how everyone else might best be assigned. As for myself, I shall continue what I've begun in Sharlion. I should also like to steal the services of an Archon or two.
And thereby gain access to a greater range of reading material. I will help with that.
Allow me to offer my assistance. I have some small amount of experience in the field of research.
Alizé and I would also like to help, if you would have us.
Anything to understand even a fraction of what our father and the Forum might be thinking.
Of course! The more the merrier.
Right. The rest of us will make the journey to Thavnair. Thoughts? Objections?
I passed through Thavnair on my way to infiltrate the Empire, and though I'm not qualified to give a guided tour, I did gain a sense of where things lie.
I'll be happy to have you along then. So for this group, it will be you, me, and Urianje.
Give me a moment afterwards, and I'll supply you with all the details of Nadana's request. Consider this hall our rendezvous point once our respective tasks are complete. May our investigations prove fruitful.
Thank you.
Set. Just the four of you, was it?
Three. I'm already attuned to the crystal in Thavnir.
You are? Oh, I would have preferred more test subjects. Oh, well, never mind. If our three travellers could line up here, please.
is fine. Take a deep breath, and I'll soon have you soaring through the ether. Oh, and one last thing. You might experience a teensy-weensy touch of violent ethereal sickness. Good luck!
What?
Thavnir, home to city-state Rudz At'Han. Rising from the southeast waters of the Bounty, this Isle of Plenty served as the battleground for a conflict between two peoples. Their cultures bled into one another until a unique amalgamation was distilled from the chaos, in a process not unlike their precious alchemy. Once solidified as a single nation, an adamant stance of neutrality would hold invaders at bay. For a time. Now across this vibrant isle creeps a fog of malice. What choice do you have? What chance? Against such an insidious foe.
Seen fairer faces after a bout of bad shellfish. Let me bring you something to drink. That should help settle your bellies.
There was a note with Kryl's instructions. Don't let Estinian roam the markets alone. He's alarmingly bad with coin.
What happened here?
Their dress marks them as alchemists. I see no evidence of injury or poison.
Thinkest thou they but slumber?
I believe so. Whether it is by choice is another question entirely.
Oh, we have guests. You must excuse the poor welcome. Long days and longer nights have taken their toll, as you can see. I am Vashan, servant to the satrap. My task was, in fact, to wake these good men and women, if you will allow. People of the great work, I come bearing new scales.
Scales? We have new scales?
Yes, my friends. Gather round. I have them right here.
Now I can continue my experiment.
Many thanks.
One for me.
Those are dragon scales.
Yes, such materials are vital to their most pressing research.
And we are fortunate to have them. Our experiments are so close to bearing fruit. Soon we will have a talisman capable of nullifying the etheric emissions from that accursed tower. Did I say something wrong? Are you not here with Vashan? Wait, who are you people? Of course! You're the one Kryl sent. The warrior of light we've been waiting for.
Ah, oh, this is a day of celebration. Praise be to Sindaruva!
The winds have shifted. I feel it. The end to our toil is near.
I feel it too. My head hasn't been this clear in days.
Tell me, how did you acquire those scales?
Curious that it concerns you so. But worry not. They were freely given by the dragon with whom our satrap has forged a lawful pact.
That is well.
You must be quite familiar with Dragonkin, yes?
Is this their congealed blood I see on your weapon?
Speaking of dragon blood, you yourself have been infused with it, have you not? I should like to draw a file or two, if so. Now, see here.
Come along. I must insist that you visit our laboratory.
Cease your shoving, or so help me.
Oh dear, your poor companion. What with the new scales and your timely arrival, my colleagues are a little giddy with excitement. No harm will come to him, I promise. Meanwhile, shall we find a quiet place to talk? As you may have guessed, I am Nidana, the alchemist who sent the request to your mistress Kryl. We have workshops across the nation collaborating on this research project. But it is here, at the Great Work, where I collate our results. Come with me, all of you, and I can explain the crux of the situation. Yes, that would be Raad's at Han. Hardly anyone has been allowed in or out since our troubles with the tower began. The faithful citizens huddle inside the city walls, and commerce has all but ground to a standstill. I pity the satrap, the trials he must be facing. Well, he is the most important person in Raad's at Han. Long ago, this island was home to two tribes of Matanga, the Gajasura and the Arkasodra. When the Aura came to these shores, it was the Arkasodra with whom they joined forces. Together, they defeated the warlike Gajasura, forcing them to flee Thavnir altogether. Peace and prosperity reigned for a time, until a clan of Hjor from the mainland decided they wanted the island for themselves. It was a direct ancestor of the present satrap who arbitrated that conflict and welded the warring factions into the nation we know today. And ever since, a member of that esteemed lineage has inherited this somewhat unique position. You see, by and large, the state is run by the people, but when problems arise, it is the satrap who mediates a solution. The stability provided by the satrap is what has allowed Raad's at Han to thrive all these years. And it was the satrap himself who entrusted us with this duty. We will not fail him, nor our countrymen.
What is the delay with the vessel? I told you I need to adjust those ratios. I come all this way to admire one of my splendid towers, and what do I find? Fools! Attempting to ward off its tempering influence with magic trinkets. I seem to recall a similar experiment in ages past. What was that man's name? Oh something? Oween?
Another body, another time. Who could be expected to remember every trivial detail?
Allowing them to construct such handy talismans would be counterproductive to my plans. And yet, I find myself deathly curious. How will they manage this feat with the limited knowledge and resources at their disposal? Complications be damned. For we cannot escape the nature of our souls. And I, as ever, am my own worst enemy.
Thank you.